So it was year 2000, came to AFSOC, got qualified in the H model gunship as the nav. So you get qualified as a navigator first at Little Rock in your undergraduate navigator training. When I got to the squadron, I quickly realized I was the first female navigator. It was a fact, but it wasn't something that I really dwelled on. The unit itself wanted good operators. So if you were really good at your job, they didn't care if you were black, white, green, yellow, male, female. They just wanted to go out and execute.
I grew up with all brothers, and so they'll give me a hard time a lot about being a girl. But no one here seems to really care. All they care about here is, like, if you, like I said, if you're competent, like if you show up for work, ready to work, and you take pride in your work, if you're good at what you do.
Hearing about Lieutenant Courtney, it can't help but reflect when I was a lieutenant and how excited I was to come to the mission, and then after 9/11 to go and fight.
Go.
Like I said, I can at least wake myself up in the morning, look in the mirror, and just know that, like, I'm pushing myself to the limits. I did it with neuroscience, just pretty much out of pure stubbornness, to see if I could. Got that degree and was like, well, now what? I definitely don't want to do that anymore. And so now I'm here, and I'm just, I'm loving the challenge, and I'm loving pushing myself and seeing how far I can go. I feel like I've been set up for success with the amount of females who have already been through the community and done incredibly well. So they've set a high bar that I hope I can live up to someday, but it's definitely made it easier, just the proven history of competence that's gone before me.
The thought of being the first was the furthest from my mind. It wasn't until years later when people would bring it up, when I'd have a young airman tell me that hearing what I was able to do in AFSOC gave them the confidence to volunteer and to raise their hand to go forward. And it's taken years to be really comfortable in my own skin and recognize that taking the time out to mentor, to have a conversation, or to speak in public, if that can inspire young men and women to realize that, hey, I'm just a woman doing my job. You're just a man doing your job. It doesn't, your gender doesn't matter.